Only few students have joined, so we shall start the class. Today is the last class. So I would like I was in yesterday's class. I was just saying about the compilers. In compilers, I was saying about in compilers, I was saying about the control flow graph, and the control flow graph in yesterday's example, it varies from different to different. As we know, what is a control flow graph? Control flow graph is nothing but it represents for nodes and vertices. We know that, but control flow graph is for only the control transfer. Is for only the control transfer, and that control transfer can be simple expression also, any kind of basic block. And that basic block can be any kind of the statement also. It can be a simple statement. It also can be some control statement, something like conditional statement also it can be. And it also can be some loop statement, for statement, if else statement, do while statement. It can be anything. So control flow graph, it varies for different statement. Like suppose if we want to represent for simple expression, for simple expression, if we want to represent for any control statement, so simple expression takes the entry of the statement, and it just simply does. And in yesterday's class, I was just saying about the control statement for the example, something like A star B. For the example, something like A star B. So let me do one example. Something like A star B. A star B. So for this, how it is going to represent the control for A star B? Anyhow, it is an assignment statement, so it is required for it to assign to some other variable, something like Z. So how the control would transfer here for such a expression, and how is the control statement for for loop, do while loop, and for if else a statement? So I would like to represent saying yes. I'll take here some paint. So how does it makes an entry? So it as the control enters, and we will be having here the as the control enters, we'll have the control as it is entering. And as it enters, now suppose I would like to show here the control statement for if else. If else. If this condition in inner of this, if this condition, I would like to write here some, can we write here? If this condition, the condition something like, I give some condition, n is equal to or n is greater than or less than 5. N is greater than or less than 5. So for such a condition, if this condition is true, if this condition is true, it goes for one statement, for one step of statement. If condition is false, it goes for another step of statement. So if this condition is true, if this condition is false. So we have different control flow for different statement. Now the statement which I have taken is here if else. If I would like to write if else, which I am taking if else. So what the condition which I have taken? The entry of the loop, the entry of the loop, and once the loop has been entered, once the loop has been entered, it checks for the condition. If the condition is true, it does some evaluation, it does some evaluation or computation. If the condition is false, if the condition is false, it goes for exit. If the condition is false, so here some evaluation, assume that I am doing some computation. If the condition is true, I am computing something like y is equal to y is equal to some n plus m. I am computing some y is equal to n plus m. So if this is on condition is true, this is on condition is true. But on condition true also, it should go to the exit statement. How does it goes to the exit statement? Because it once the control is true, the control will not be in the same. So on the control statement true, now here I would like to represent one. So this is the entry. This is as the entry, we also represent here something like here as one. This is one, the entry, and the condition is true. To check the condition is this is the second, and this is for third. If the condition is true, and if the condition is on true, compute, then go for exit. Then here also, if the condition is false, maybe I'm giving some other condition to work. Sorry, maybe I'm giving some other computation, or that other computation can also be on false. Maybe I'm giving some other computation to work, something like y is equal to n minus m. Y is equal to n minus m. So this it has to compute on false. So it has to compute on false. Else on true it has to compute this. Then both the computation should have their own end. So after completing this computation, the control will come to an exit. The control will come to an exit. So that exit, the control will come to an exit. And this control also comes to an exit. This control also comes to an exit. So here we say it as the node as 3, and here the node as 4. Here the node is as 4, and this is the node as 5. This is the node as 5. So this is how it does. Now this is called as control flow. This is called as control flow graph. This is called as control flow graph. But this is one example which I have given for the statement called as if-else statement. This is one example which I have given for if-else statement. This is for if-else statement. Same way, how the control graph will be for loop, or will be for do while loop, or will be for some simple statement. That simple statement can be some assignment expressions. So how it can be? So let me go for another example. In yesterday's class, I was saying you another example, some assignment example, something like A is multiplied by B. For such an expression, how the control will transfer? How the control will transfer for such an expression? So here the node here there is no such condition. There is no such condition. Yes, are you there? Somebody has logged in. Today the strength is very less. Are you there? Yes, am I audible? Am I audible? Am I audible? Mukund, Prashant, Sonia, Pranali, Pallavi, Pratiksha, Unkar is there?
Sorry,
am I audible? Today, Unkar, your voice is getting disturbance. Unkar, your voice is getting disturbance. I think you have some network issue. Okay. So, did you saw first example which I have shown, control flow example? So, the control flow example which represents for the Okay, now another example, but this example is a simple example. So simple statement, neither I have here any condition nor for loop. So it is an assignment statement. So let me assign it to some y. So let me assign it to y. So first of all, here the code will be generated for a is a will be moved to some register, then to that register it will get multiplied by a instruction code or by instruction code like mult. So that mult will get multiplied to that register, and later again it uses the memory movement register. So the memory movement register will move the result into an some y. So this from y again the memory will be allocated. So from there it start getting, I mean it will start allocating, because y is getting now the address allocation, so it will get executed. So now how the control will be transferred to such an assignment expression? Here direct hit is there for an assignment expression. As the node, when the control enters, it just sees for a is multiplied by b, a is multiplied by b. So how does it takes this such an expression? Directly it will take this such an expression, but here direct evaluation or the computation will be there. Y is equal to a, but it takes time. Why it takes time? A is directly multiplied and it directly goes to the end exit statement, or it comes out of this control and goes to the next statement. So likewise, another example we should see now. So this is a direct, but it has to come to an end. How does it come to an end? Again, the control will come to an end, that is the exit statement. So this oval, whatever the oval sign, it is nothing but a node. So here also I would like to represent by a node. That node is nothing but oval also, and some author will represent using the oval, some author will represent using the rectangle sign. So here whatever the flow is there, that flow you indicate as the edge, and as you all know the definition of the control flow represents the control flow or the computation during the execution of a program or applications. So the control flow are mostly used in the static analysis as well as the compiler applications, but such control flows are used in all types of the program. It is not like that. So control flow represents for all the basic blocks, right from the simple statements to the, now here you just see this example. So in this example, but this example, yesterday's example I have solved, which I have kept here, a star b. So that is finished. Now another example, the control flow represents for how the control is going to transfer. Now here is an example, a is assigned to 0, and the basic block here, the basic block is 1, and this is treated to be as the level 2. Why? Because there is a link between them. Now here b is having some incrementing value, so b plus 1, and c is having the calculated value of the b with c, with its c, and a is having some b is multiplied by 2, and here this is what the block it takes on true or false. So and returns to C. So here A is the basic block, is the basic block, and this block is treated to be as the other block. Here the level jumps on true or false, and this is what the condition which I have shown on true or false, how does it takes. On true it does some computation. What is that computation? It is going to the level 1, this block, it is going to the level 1 on true. So A is less than n means it is going to the level 1. So A is less than 1 means it is going to the level 1, else it is returning to C. Else it is returning to C. Who is that else it is returning to C means? Basic block 3, it is returning to that. Who is that basic block? Itself, the end. Itself is the end of this block. On false, it is coming out of this loop, and on true, it is going back to the basic block statement of 2, basic block statement of 2. So here, all these are basic block statements only, but here there is a interlinking of the variables, because each variable expressions or each variable result is dependent on the other. As C computation is dependent on B, and as A is dependent on B here. So that is what this completes block 1, 2, 3, this basic block 2 statement, statement 3, statement 4, statement 5 are considered to be as the basic block 2. And this first statement is treated to be as the basic block 1, as it is taking a initial value where it is not related to anyone else, but here it is related. But finally here it will have the computed value of A, but it is not going to return to some basic block 1, or it is going to return only to basic block 2 itself. That's what this initial value is nowhere concerned, is nowhere related it. And also it makes some loop entry also, not loop entry, the entry of the control, the entry of the control. So this is how, and on true it is going to do this job of returning back to the level basic block 2, level 1. Who is that level 1? Basic block 1 on true. And on false it is coming out, that is returning to the C. Who is that C means? C is equal to C plus B. It is computing that and returning the value by exiting. So this is how one kind of the other kind of the, but here what could be the optimization in control flow? In this control flow, the optimization can be A is equal to Z. A is equal to 0. This can be optimized. Only we can begin the task entry or the computation entry from B also we can begin. So this can be optimized. Means only the basic block 2 and basic block 3 are the required utmost code or required utmost control flow, optimum control flow. So this can be removed. So this is what, how we can optimize. But here basically we need to understand how the control is flowing for the execution, and the control flow itself represents the execution of the program. So this is how the another example also we shall see the another example. So this whatever I have narrated here, this is for for loop. This is what the loop is entering. If the condition is true, it goes to the other condition. If the condition is false, it goes to the other node in the sense, it computes some other expression. So both of them has to come finally to an exit loop, and the loop which it has to return back for n number of times. So now here is also another kind of example. Now A is equal to 0. This is the first node entry. A is equal to 0, but it itself is entering with a loop. This itself represents as the block. This itself, one more example I would like to represent you, saying as while, because here I have taken here the example of if else. You know very well that on true it has to do some task, and on false it has to do some task, but ultimately both of them has to come out, because here is a flow that is pending there itself only. So that has to come out and go to the exit part, and this also go to the exit part, should go to the exit part, and while condition also should go to the exit part. So before understanding this example, sorry, before knowing this example, we should know once again here if else and while. Now you have come to know if else. How is the if else? Now I would like to show you for the while. I would like to show you for while. How is the while statement? Now while statement. Now for while statement, it has to, now in while also we have two kind of while. So while statement directly does, if the while statement directly does with some conditions, something like n is greater than 0, n is greater than 0. So here is a directly condition. So how the while n is greater than 0, it has to perform some task. What task? It compute some task, some y is equal to n plus x or n plus I something, okay, where n is, okay, for such a things, how it has to do, how the compiler has to make an entry. So how the compiler will do? Now the loop will be not the loop, so while loop is going to start. So how does the while loop will start? The loop will take entry for the condition, and this condition also I told you very long back, in some book it represents by rectangle and in some book it represents by showing the oval sign. It represents by showing the oval sign also. So the loop is going to enter now. I'll just show using the oval sign. As n is greater than 0, this is a while the loop has been started, and this is before this also some author will represent by root node also. Root node, this is the root node. Root node represents the one, and from the root node it makes a path, and this is condition going to become the second root node, and it creates here the two path. As on true, it creates some condition, and on false, not condition, it computes some expression. On true, if the condition is true, again I have taken here rectangle, but instead of rectangle, I can take here the circle sign to represent the node. So here it is going to compute for y is equal to n plus x. Now on false, what it should not do anything else, so it is going to come to an exit statement on false. It is not doing anything. It is going to an exit state. So here the control will be here only. So how the control has to finish here? The control should finish here by going to the exit statement. The control should give to an end by going to an exit statement. So this is how for while loop. This is how for while loop. And how it is for one more statement we have seen. This is for while, and here one more we have seen, how is for if else. Now this if else, now the same example also I can represent. While b is equal to 3, and it has to perform some task. So the same example also I can take here. Now this is how while. How could be the if? Now if for to represent the if, let me go a is equal to 1 and b is equal to 5, else b equal to 2, else b is equal to 2. If the condition a is equal to 1, then only it is executing b is equal to 5. If condition is not true, it is executing b is equal to 2. So how here? Come to the root node. Root node, from the root node, it is going for the statement. It is going for the what is the root node? At the root node, after the root node, sorry, after the root node, we have an assignment, that is a is equal to a equal to 0 and b is equal to 1 and a is equal to 0, b is equal to 1, b is equal to 1, c is equal to this one, third node, c is equal to 3, c equal to 3. Now if condition starts here, if a is equal to 1, if a equal to 1, what it has to do? It has to compute for on true, it has to compute for b equal to 5, b equal to 5. And if this condition is false, it has to give rise to another. Now here only, in this part only, there is also some sequence of statement. If after this if statement, parallel to this we have while, why because if this is a first statement, it has to complete this so it has to take while b is equal to 3, so if anyhow it is having true and false also, so on false again it has to come to an end, and this is what the false and this is what the true condition, which it has also come to an end. While condition, for this while condition, on true it has to perform a is equal to a plus 1, and on false here how the exit condition is going, so on false it has to exit b, if b is not equal to 3, it has to come out. So here you need to know here how the condition is for if else statement also, so I have shown you that if else part also. Once again here, just the loop is going to enter from the root node, and from the root node it is entering to the condition, if condition, and on true and on false. On true it is performing some task and it is going to exit, and exit, for exit also we cannot leave it in the air only, we should go to a node, exit, saying yes, exit. Now this, just I'm elaborating it and I'm showing you how that if was performed. And if on false also it should go or perform some task. Now on if condition, where what was the condition? Just go back here. The condition was if a is equal to 1, if a is equal to 1, b should be performed. If a is equal to 1, so what is the condition? If statement, this is the root. Now root I cannot tell here because I must say here root only. Why? Because I'm showing here separately if else statement, else it can be in continuation to this, b is equal to 3, what it should be, sorry, c is equal to 3. If I remove this root node, what is that? C is equal to 3. C equal to 3. Now here, if a is equal to, what is the condition? Condition is that if a is equal to 1, b is equal to 5 is executed. If a is equal to 1, b equal to 5 is executed. Else if a is not equal to 1, what it should execute? It should execute b equal to 2. But this cannot be here only left out. It should terminate. This loop should terminate. This loop should terminate. This is the first path. The first path on true. This is the first path on true. On true, what it is going to do? B equal to 5 and then go to exit. On false, A is equal to second time. Maybe the data which we maybe the data which the which this flow has got, B is not, A is not equal to 1. So at that time it is going to execute B is equal to, at that time it is B is equal to 2. B equal to 2. Then this also cannot be left in air only. So this path or this control should come to an end, that is reaching to the node called as exit. So where we should make a condition where it can go for exit. So this is how if else statement. Yes, one. So all of you have listened. So this is how the class which finishes on compilers. Did you got it? Yes. So I will post in I will post in the group SP WhatsApp group. There I'll post as the notes, handwritten notes of mine for compilers. So this is how compilers gets end. Is any doubts? So still lot more examples are there based on this. This is on the basic block 1, basic block 2, basic block 3, but these are simple kinds. Now you see, if you see such an example, here is a simple example where initialization is there, where some computation is there, but here is a condition. As the condition takes, anyhow the block is going to be divided into true, on false, and then it is going to be on true, it is computing some kind of computation, that is basic block 2, and on false it is going to do some other computation, but both of them has to come to an end, that is the basic block 4, which is nothing but it has to execute this exit, which has to execute. So this is how the examples shows for different. Likewise, for do while, and for loop, and for so many different other kinds of the basic block statements it can perform. Yes, this is how. One is there, two is there.
Yes, ma'am.
Have you understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, and this is also completes your compilers chapters. Compilers chapters. So one.
Yes, ma'am.
Two. Three.
Present, ma'am.
Four.
Five. Present.
Present, ma'am.
Any doubts?
Present. Six.
Any doubt? Yes, six. Do you have any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Seven. Eight. Nine,
present, ma'am.
10, 11, 12,
present, ma'am.
Present, ma'am. 11, 13, present, ma'am.
14, 13,
present.
15, 16,
present, ma'am.
17, 16,
present, ma'am.
Okay, 18,
present, ma'am.
19, 20,
present,
21,
22,
present, ma'am.
Okay, 23,
present, ma'am.
I think you people have signal problem. Is there heavy rainfall? Shall I note from this whatever you have posted here, text?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay. Yes, thank you. I think most of the students are having some signal problem. Afterwards, you people are responding. Okay, after my call. Shall I note from here?
Ha, ma'am.
Shall I note? Okay, okay. Those I have given here can leave. I will note it down from here. Thank you all. And today I will post the handwritten notes. Okay? Onkar, are you there? Onkar. Onkar. Sonia, Mukund. Mukund. Mukund, are you there? Okay, post your attendances.